It's unboxing time. Join me today while I share what I got in my second box I received as an Island Batik ambassador. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and I just got two big boxes full of gorgeous batik fabric and other items from sponsors of the Island Batik Ambassador Program, and I want to share that with you today. So let's take a look at the luscious fabrics I got. So first I'm going to start with this fabric, which is new. This is called Playful Posies, and it should be in your local quilt shop in September. This is something I'm going to be using in a project in September. You can see all these luscious colors in here, and there's different fabrics that have flowers on, like morning glories. I'm going to show you some yardage in just a second, but you can see you've got a really great array of light, medium, and dark fabric, which I love in a fabric collection because you can do so much with it. Now, as I said, I'm going to be working on a project in September with these fabrics, and I'm going to be needing some thread. So Aurifil is one of the sponsors, and they very generously sent me some threads to use in that project. So you know you're going to be seeing Aurifil threads working on that project in September. So these threads that I have here are going to coordinate with the fabrics that I have in this bundle. So you can see that I've got some nice yellows. Some yellows and gold, like a lemon kind of, and more of a goldy color that just perfectly matches those fabrics in there, I can see. And then I've got this kind of, I don't know what I'd call this, a fuchsia color, maybe? That's going to coordinate with any of them, I think. And then we've got a couple, like a blue. You can see that blue is picking up there for sure. And then a darker, like a purple or an indigo color. So those are going to work really well with those fabrics. I'm excited to use those. And thanks to Aurifil for sending those to me. And also, of course, thanks to Island Batik for sending all these fabrics to me. I have some other fabrics. Now these are half yard cuts. I have some other fabrics that are going to coordinate with these and other fabrics that I have. And these are foundations, the foundations line from Island Batik. And what I love when I get these is it tells me what they are. So I can, if I want to get more, I know what I want to get more of. I love this turquoise. I've had that before and I absolutely love it. So you've got some solids in here. Yes, they do make solid fabrics. And then we've got, of course, other ones that have some slight patterns on them. So these are what I call, while they're their foundation line, they read as solid to me, right? So even this one will read as like a solid blue to me. So half yards of all of those, lots to play with there. Let's see. Okay, let's go over here. Let's go over some of these. So I have 2 yards. This is also Playful Posies, so like these, but 2 yards of light and 2 yards of a dark. So here I talked about these ones that look like morning glories. That's what I think in there. These look more like roses, right? I love this fabric. This is like, I think, my favorite of that line with all these different colors in it. Stunning. Love that. All right, what else? Let's see. Let's go to these. I've got some pre-cuts. So these pre-cuts are 2.5-inch strips, and these are 40 pieces. These are called Bodacious Black, so all different gradations of black. So I have some ideas of what I want to do with this. And then they also have these 5-inch strips, which are really kind of cool. So inside each of these, there's several different fabrics in here. They're all with the fabric. So I've got these colors and kind of the greens, the lime greens and aquas, blues, and we have some reds and pink, and there's even some aqua in there too. Ooh, there's some bright colors in there too. So I'll have to get into those and see what exactly is in them. But I think these are going to work really well with this pre-cut too. Now this is called Precious Pinks, and again, a gradation. So like the blacks, only this is a layer cake. So you can even put those together and that would be really stunning as well. I'm loving all these colors. Oh, they're my colors. Then I have more fabric. So these are 4 yards each, and I said they have solids, right? Black, white, and gray. There's the black, the white, and the gray. These are beautiful fabrics. I love working with them. These are so helpful to get because they will coordinate with anything I've got, and they're great for, you know, quilts where I need a lot of background fabric. Then I have some more fabric here. This is also from their foundations line. This is luscious. There's so much going on in this fabric. I just love batiks because there's always so much going on. This one is whipped cream. I've got 6 yards of whipped cream to play with. That's going to coordinate well with, it would look nice with the pinks, wouldn't it? It'll also work here, I think. So yes, there's that. And we're not stopping. There's more. So I have a pre-cut in here. Let's see if I can slide these out so I can show you the pre-cut. This one's coming up, called Bubbles, Curves, and Corners. So this is a layer cake. It's kind of slid down a bit in the packing, but you can see all the beautiful colors in here. We've got some kind of tends towards the purplish pink salmons, kind of lighter mauves, some aqua in there. Yeah, that'll work with that foundation fabric, but I have some fabric too. So I've got a light neutral and then I've got a darker one that'll coordinate beautifully with the pre-cuts here. And there's still more. So this is for the October challenge, which is to make a project using one of the patterns from byannie.com. And so if you haven't made a bag yet, I highly recommend their patterns. They're very easy to follow. They have a lot of videos to help you make them. And yeah, they have tons and tons of patterns. So they have sent me everything I need to make this little pouch is what I chose. Oh, let's get into this. I haven't opened it yet, as you can tell, right? There we go. Everything's all packaged in here. Everything I need. And let's see. All right. So we've got there soft and stable. Okay. This is a great stabilizer. I have used this before in different projects and it's really nice because it kind of scrunches up nicely, but it doesn't crease or anything. It doesn't hold any folds, but it will let things stand up. So if you're making bins, for example, you know, the ones that just make in their fabric, this is really good to use for that. Easy to stitch through as well. So I really love their soft and stable. It's a fantastic product. And then I've got fabric, of course. We've got the pattern. I've got my zipper here. And I'm making a Ditty Bag 2.0. Okay. So I kept it fairly simple because I'm not a bag maker. So I didn't want to get in over my head here. But I know there's a video tutorial on this too. So I think that's going to be very helpful. And I picked these fabrics, actually, which are not my colors. So I'm stepping outside my comfort zone, and I did that intentionally because I wanted to make this nice and bright, and I wanted to make it out of fabrics I typically wouldn't use. So it's good to stretch yourself sometimes, right? But these are gorgeous. I'm liking these more than I thought I would, actually. And the sunflowers and the black, yes, those are going to go really nicely together to make that Ditty Bag 2.0. All right, so thanks to Annie by Annie for sending me all this information, everything I need except for the sewing machine, right, to make this project coming in October. All right, I'm running out of room here. There's so much stuff, I'm running out of room. So I have more things to show you, but I need to clear this first. So just give me a second, I'll do that, and I'll show you what else I got in box number 2 that arrived on the doorstep the other day. Now, Hobbs Batting is also a sponsor of the Island Batik Ambassador Program. They've been very generous with donating us all different kinds of batting. So it's great because there are some I have not tried before. So it's a perfect opportunity for me to use these in the projects and see how they work. So thanks very much to Hobbs for sending me all this batting. So first thing I got was Thermor, which I have never used before. So I had to look up and see what is Thermor batting. Okay, so it is ultra thin, non-bearding, and this is a queen size, just in this little package. So it's really thin and it's polyester batting. So it's one that you can use for placemats, table runners, you know, even wall hangs, places where you don't want that lofty batting, you don't need to see the quilting, that type of thing. So I think this is going to be really great for making those type of projects. And I've never tried it before. Then I also got some of the Hobbs 8020 polyester cotton batting in black. So I know I had those bodacious blacks. So I know that I'm going to be able to use this batting in a project using those and other dark fabrics. So this is great to get this. This is also a queen size. And then here's something else I have not used before either, and that's a fusible batting. I know a lot of people love fusible battings. I've never tried them. I'll have the opportunity to now because this is a cotton batting and this is a queen size as well. It's 80 cotton and 20% polyester actually. It says fusible cotton batting, but it's actually 80-20 blend. So I'm looking forward to using this because I typically spray baste my quilts. So this will save me that step. So I can hardly wait to use this. And then, oh, this just seems so luxurious. This is the Hobbs Tuscany Collection Silk Blend. So this is a throw size, 60 by 60. And this is silk and polyester. And I can hardly wait to work with this because I've heard it's really, really nice. It doesn't hold creases and things like that. It's lightweight, breathable, right? So it'd be great for a lap throw. And yes, silk just sounds so luxurious, doesn't it? And then last, but certainly not least, we have another Tuscany collection, and this is the Supreme 100% unbleached cotton. So all cotton. This is a twin size, 72 by 96 is what this one is. This is ideal for medium or dark fabrics, it says, and you can quilt it up to 3 or 4 inches apart. So that's kind of nice. You can just, you know, you can have the denser quilting on this, and I think it's going to work really, really well. They have so much information on the front. I'm just reading everything here because it says here, you know, it's washable. It shrinks 5 to 6%. Always nice to know how much it's going to shrink, right? But that would be great for projects too. So the toughest part about the Hobbs batting is where do I store it, right? But I better get making projects so I use it up. I have one more thing to share with you as well that came in the ambassador box. And that is there's always a surprise package for us. It's always all wrapped up. And I love the trim they use because it looks cute on sale and as a collar. But this is something that I am not opening yet. So I'm not sure. I know it's fabric, but I'm not sure exactly what it is yet. So I will wait and open this later. You'll see that video when I am able to open it. We're not able to open these for a while. We're not able to share them for a while. So when I open that, I'll be doing another video and showing you what's inside, what fabric collection is inside. So again, thanks so much to Island Batik and all the sponsors for sending all of this to me as an ambassador. I really appreciate it. I love working with all these products. I typically use Hobbs batting in my products anyway, so getting more of their product is great. And Aurifil I use all the time on my machine too. So thanks so much. I'm looking forward to making these projects with everything that's been sent to me. So stay tuned because I'll be sharing some of those with you as the months go on. Thanks so much for watching today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. And for more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.